All week long, we've been giving you exclusive access to StyleWeek Providence, from meeting the designers to style tips inspired by the runway. And tonight, one of reality television's favorite couples will serve as style ambassadors for the event. Alex McCord and Simon Van Kempen join us live in the studio this morning to co-host the road show with us. We are so thrilled to have both of you on today.
Thank you so much. We're glad to be here.
And thank you for joining us. Now,
well, thank you.
This is the second time that you've participated in StyleWeek Providence. So why the interest? Why are you serving this time around?
Do we love fashion?
We do. We love fashion almost as much as we love each other.
And
that says a lot.
Yes, it does. One of our dear friends, Rosanna Osanel, is the director of StyleWeek Providence, and we met her at Fashion Week in New York a couple of years ago, and she got us involved, and now we're in.
Excellent.
And one of the things we love to do is support emerging designers. I mean,
yeah.
You know, it's great to go to New York Fashion Week where you have the really big names, but before they're big names, they're small names,
right.
Small, you know, showing in smaller shows, and that's when they need the support, and the more sort of publicity and press that we can help them bring, the better for them.
Fantastic. Now, both of you are very fashionable. You know, you've done things from the artistic to the daring. So, how would you describe your style?
Eclectic.
Yeah, it depends on the day. I mean, I choose outfits that sometimes are a little bit pushing the envelope, and sometimes it's too much for some people, but
yeah, nice
if
pass.
I enjoy it, that's all that matters.
Excellent. Now, many of our viewers know you from your numerous seasons on The Real Housewives of New York. What was that experience like for you?
I think sometimes it was fun, sometimes we wanted to throw things at the TV. One of the things that we are very lucky about is that we have each other, and when
yeah.
we were on the hot seat, we've been so together.
Yeah, look, one of the bad things of reality TV is that it has caused the breakups of a lot of marriages, but it's exacerbated the problems. I mean, we've seen, you know,
yes.
Simon and Tamara from the OC show break up. It looks like Nene's broken up from Greg in Atlanta. Because we were on the show together so much, it was a partnership in a way, and you know, when
Absolutely.
Alex was getting beaten up or loved, I was getting beaten up or loved as well. So we were in it together, and 4 years we survived, and we've come out the other side as strong as we were when we went in.
That's
yeah.
right.
That's nice that you were always staying together through it. Now you won't be appearing in the next season, but is this it for you? I mean, are you going to continue with any TV? What's next?
Well, we at the moment are concentrating on our home line, Alex Home.
That's right.
Which is 100% Egyptian cotton sheets and towels. So
wow.
we're very busy with that. And you will probably see us on TV again, too.
Yeah, look, I think one thing that we didn't have to consider so much when we signed up 4 or 5 years ago for Housewives was our boys were then, you know, when we signed the contract, they were 0 and 2.
Mm.
You know, they're now 6 and 8.
Oh, wow.
And, you know, they have to have an input whether they want to be back on TV again. And, you know, we have such a strong family unit that they really have to participate in the decision as well. So we'll see. But we've been speaking to various networks, and I wouldn't rule it out just yet.
And you mentioned your line before. Tell us about it, what people can expect to see.
We wanted to bring to the people the champagne tastes on a beer budget, if you will.
I like that.
Egyptian cotton is one of the most beautiful long staple cottons in the world.
Mm-hmm.
And
so look at you, speaking of the jargon now, the ELS, extra long staple. It's like we were in Cairo in July, and we spent 4 days at the factory. It was a massive sort of download of information, looking
wow.
at how it's woven. You know, at the factory, they take in the cotton bales, basically, and they weave the actual cotton string itself, and then it's woven into towels or sheets. It was a great exercise.
And we learned that you shouldn't concentrate so much on thread count for sheets, but more how it feels to the hand.
Interesting.
Yeah,
that's a fun fact for you, so when you're looking for sheets,
people
feel it
fudge
in your
the
hand.
Thread count. I mean, there really is no such thing as 1,200 thread count sheets, although you'll see them advertised in stores. But I won't blow the cover on them just yet.
That's an expose.
I was gonna say. We'll leave it here. All right. Well, thank you so much for being here. We're excited to have you sticking around throughout the entire show with us.